Hello friend, welcome to Marine Engineering Hub. This is the part 2 of the cooling water system. In my part 1, I have explained this two diagram. And after that, in today, I will explain what are the mode of cooling used in a cooling water system. What are the advantage of that? And after that, I will explain the auxiliary cooling water system. And after that, I will explain the different component used in the cooling water system and what are the advantage of that. So please remain tuned till last, you will learn a lot. So this is the part 2. If you haven't watched part 1, please go and watch, then only you will understand this part 2. So let's begin the video. In cooling water system, basically the mode of cooling means the fresh water or sea water. These are the two modes by which the engine can be cooled. In earlier engine, means in earlier model of the engine, basically seawater cooling system was preferred and was used, but with the development of freshwater cooling system, the seawater cooling system become obsolete, and there are many reasons why it has happened. So let's see. Freshwater cooling system is majorly preferred as it has proven several advantages as follow. Seawater cooling system pipeline are suspected to corrosion. So as you know, seawater is corrosive in nature, and hence over a period of time it will cause corrosion to the pipeline and it will eat away the pipeline. So material getting corroded and their renewal proved to be very costly affair. So as the seawater is corrosive, it will eventually corrode the material of the pipelines and the components of the engine parts. And hence, their renewal after a specific period of time in a dry dock proved to be a very costly affair. So, a seawater cooling system loses its charms and freshwater cooling system become more and more used. Now, also the salt present in a seawater getting deposited providing hindrance to the heat flow. As you know, the seawater is salty because of sodium chloride present in that. That sodium chloride, when at heated temperature, causes the salt deposition in the system, leading to the hindrance of heat flow and hence inefficient heat transfer. So that was the major problem of seawater cooling system. Okay, seawater cooling system was an open system and waste heat recovery was minimal. So as you know that in freshwater cooling system, as I have told you earlier, that freshwater cooling system heat is being used for generation of fresh water. But seawater is an open system, means the suction is taken from the sea and again it is going back at the sea. So the heat which was gained during the jacket cooling was wasted back to the sea. It was not properly utilized, which was utilized in a freshwater system because it was a closed system. So what are the advantages of the freshwater cooling? So first thing is that using distilled water for cooling provide better heat transfer as there will minimal scale issue. So as you have seen here in this diagram, that the whole system is closed. Okay, the whole system is closed. Therefore, we are using the freshwater. Basically, the freshwater is distilled water. Okay. And hence there will be minimum scale formation and better heat transfer. Okay. Second, it is a closed system, so better waste heat recovery. So as I have told you that the waste recovery of the freshwater system is good because we are using the heat gain during jacket cooling for generation of fresh water. Okay, better control over system means what control? Temperature control, master and slave controller with ST and LT circuit formation and smooth temperature variation without thermal stress. So as I have told you in my earlier video that with the implementation of the master and slave controller, okay, we are smooth transiting the temperature and we are maintaining the temperature very smoothly. Means suppose if you want to increase 1 to 2 degree, it is increased slowly in a systematic way such that the material not undergo severe thermal stress. Also, the smooth control means what? Correct temperature means whatever we have set, that temperature is maintained with the minimum fault, and hence this controller have a very good efficiency. That cannot be achieved in an open system in seawater system. Problem of corrosion is eliminated, as fresh water, or you can say distilled water, is not corrosive in nature because it doesn't contain the corrosive agent such as sodium chloride and the other salt particles, which erodes away the material by reacting with that, by oxidizing with that. So that problem is eliminated by using fresh water cooling system. So now let's see how an auxiliary cooling system works. So first let me show you the component. This is the header tank, this is the cooler, this is the inbuilt auxiliary pump, this is the motor driven pump, water pump, and this is the heater. So as you can see, the water coming out from the engine, suppose the temperature is around 78 degree or 75 degree. Suppose that in water coming out from the engine, temperature 75 degrees Celsius is coming here, is been pumped by a pump, and the depending upon the temperature requirement, it is further heated up, and that water is going here and coming and waiting here. This is the three-way control valve, which will regulate the mixing of preheated water and the cooled water. Okay, now this water, a part of water is going for cooling, okay, and a part is going directly to the engine. This part of water is going here and part is going for cooling, and that cool water is again mixing here, and that water ultimately, the temperature we need to maintain at the inlet is 65 degrees Celsius. That water is being fed up to a pump which is providing the cooling. While cooling, it is, the water is gaining heat as it is cooling the jacket, turbocharger and cylinder head. After cooling, the water gaining heat coming back here, and again it is fed to the pump and again further heated and again wetting here. And same way this circuit is been working. Basically, the control, the throttling of this three-way valve is been controlled by measuring the temperature, inlet temperature. Means the, sensing the inlet temperature, the three-way valve bypass the cooler depending upon the temperature. When the engine as it standstill condition, at that time here also inbuilt heater, this heater will be heated by a steam to maintain the temperature such that thermal stress doesn't fall. Okay. So this is how an auxiliary cooling water system is working. Very simple, okay. In a synopsis, you can say the water is coming out from the engine. The water is coming out from the engine, is been heated up, and after that, it is coming here, it is wetting here. The water, amount of water mixing is controlled by thermostatic valve such that the cooled water and the heated water is mixed such that correct temperature water is been fed up to a system. To maintain any leakage in the system, a header tank is provided, which is making up any leakage which is occurring through a pump gland or to a cooler, anything that is made up by the header tank. So now let's see what are the component in the cooling water system. So basically, the high temperature pump or a steam heater pump, as you can see, this is the high temperature pump and this is a steam heater pump. In this diagram, you can see this is a high temperature pump and this is a steam heater pump. So basically, these two are provided so that in normal condition, the pump will raise up the pressure of around 4 to 5 bar. But when the engine is stopped, at that time, this preheater pump will run and it will also maintain the pressure around 4 to 5 bar in the system. Okay, so basically, these are the component. Now let's see freshwater generator. This is the freshwater generator. As you can see, this is the inlet of the freshwater generator water coming in from the jacket outlet. Freshwater generator uses the high temperature water coming out from the main engine outlet to use as a primary source of heat for evaporation of its liquid. By doing so, ST of the engine outlet is used for water production in ship and excess heat recovery is taking place. So, what do I mean by that is this freshwater generator is using the heat gain by the system and that heat is been fed through freshwater generator which is using that heat for the production of fresh water and also providing cooling. It means suppose the outlet is 80 degrees Celsius, heat water is coming here, it getting in, it is evaporating the seawater for freshwater production and coming out from here and returning back here like that. While doing so, the inlet temperature of water for 80, but as it is evaporating the seawater, it is losing the heat also. So its temperature will fall down and the outlet temperature might be 72 to 75 and that water is again coming back and coming to the control valve. So basically, as you can see, the inlet temperature was 80 and the outlet was 72. So freshwater generator is doing the two work. First, it is utilizing the excess heat which is gained in the system for water production, and second, it is cooling the system also. So it is providing two efficiency. Now this is a three-way master control valve. As you can see here, the water is basically, one is the coming from the outlet of the jacket, one is coming from LT cooler. So basically the amount of mixing doing and controlling and throttling is been done by this three-way valve. This three-way valve is throttling the amount of water such that correct temperature is maintained, and this is the LT heat exchanger, LT cooling system, this LT cooler, this LT cooler you can say, or this LT cooler you can say, this LT cooler is provided here. Okay, basically exchanging the heat. Now deaeration chamber, this is a dome shaped thing provided after the, just before the inlet to the pump, so that any air pocket in the system can be removed to prevent cavitation occurring. Basically deaeration chamber is provided, as I have told you earlier here, the main purpose of deaeration is to prevent any air pocket in the system to be vented out through header tank, because if it is not there, in that case cavitation will occur and the pump will get damaged. As you know, as the temperature of the liquid increases, the vapor point means the chances of forming vapor and the chances of cavitation also increases. To ensure that any air pocket, if created, that to be vented out by deaeration vessels. Okay, now let's see the header tank. This is provided at a height, means in above the boiler platform, so that it maintain a positive head, so that any loss in the water in the system is been compensated by a header tank. Header tank also causes two things. It also provide help to dose the cooling water system. For dosing of cooling water system is been done from the header tank, and it is also provided to compensate any water loss which has taken place due to the evaporation leakage in the system. It also acts as a venting system. As I have told you, the vent from the deaeration chamber is coming to a through doing the venting through a header tank. Okay, it also helps to recognize any contamination by observing the tank surface, such that oil trace floating. So very important point. Suppose the system has any internal leakage, means suppose the water system has any leakage. Okay, in that case the water, this is a closed system, so in header tank what will happen, any leakage in the system mixing up with the oil or any trace, that will come and will collect in a header tank, and that can be observed, and by seeing that we can ensure that okay, some leakage has occurred in the system, and that from that we will know, by observing the surface of header tank we will know whether any leakage in the system is occurring or not. Moreover, header tank is provided with a alarm, low level alarm, so that to prevent any air entrance from the header tank, alarm is provided such that alarm will come if the header tank level goes up down. Also, if there is leakage in the system is excessive, the alarm will indicate that any crack or any broken pipe has taken place because of that water loss is occurring. So I hope you understand different component of the cooling water system, like DSN chamber, header tank and different thing, and how it is worked, and the auxiliary cooling water system. So friend, please do like and subscribe my video, and please share, and have a good day. Thank you friend. Image credit goes to maindiesel.co.uk. Thank you.